you've got to believe that in that race, it's going to be very difficult. Even if Governor Edwards could raise money, it's going to be very difficult for him to win that race in a runoff.
Jim, you know, I'm thinking about the election between Edwards and Roemer when Roemer became governor. And Edwards, after losing the general election, he dropped out. He knew that he was not going to be able to win. Now, why would he decide to stay in a race now? And likewise, and I know people are going to get angry with me here, but, you know, Mary Landrieu doesn't look very good right now. You know, her main argument has been defeated. We all agree that she has a tough race, and she can only hope that she can somehow garner more of people to come out to vote, and only hope that the Republicans become complacent. So if she can't raise as much money, and certainly Republicans can throw money down here, and the third party groups can do so, is she going to pull an Edwards in like Edwards did with Roemer?
I think there, you raised several issues there, Steve. I think there's more of a chance of Landrieu maybe pulling an Edwards than Edwards doing it again. In 1987, in the governor's race, Edwards was the governor, number one. He held the seat. And number two, he was not leading. He was behind Roemer, a complete unknown. And Roemer really had not spent that much money. So as a consequence, I think he saw the writing on the wall. I'll tell you what, I weighed from the very beginning. The same arguments we're making as to why Edwards cannot win this election, we could have made 4 months ago when he decided to run this election. Nothing is new out here. I think here's the difference. Back then, he knew he couldn't win. He was young. He still had a life to come back, as he proved, to come back and win another term as governor. This time around, you know what? I don't think he cares, Steve. I think that at 87, he is relishing the fact that wherever he goes, he gets mobbed by people, whether they're going to vote for him or not. He gets lots of attention. He's selling books. He's in a heyday on his rehabilitation tour. I think he's got a young son and kids, and he wants to make a legacy that he went out as a very popular guy. If he wins one or he loses one at this stage in his life, I don't think he cares, because if he's got any reservations now about the runoff, those same reservations are there when he ran for this office to begin with, knowing he had an uphill fight. Now, Landrieu's in a different situation. This is kind of an all-time deal for her. If it was not such a major race, I think she would consider not running, for rather pulling out of the race and just shutting it down. I think a lot is going on in terms of discussions with the National Party, the Senatorial Campaign Committee, the National Democratic Party. Those discussions are going to take place over the next couple of days, and they're going to have an influence on this thing, because she's, you know Cassidy, in spite of the fact that they don't need Cassidy's vote, 2016 comes up, and there's twice the number of Republicans on the ballot that are going to be at risk. So this thing could flip around 2 years from now. So there's a lot in the mix here to where if Cassidy can really have the money, will Landrieu stay in? Will the Democrats actually back her up nationally, put that money in down here? If they do, I think she'll go ahead and roll the dice and take a shot, not go out as a quitter. But if she doesn't have that backup, she may decide, look, I got this $2 million home in Washington. I can become a big shot lobbyist and enjoy the good life. So I think we're going to see a lot of soul searching over the next few days for her to make that final decision. Edwards, I think, is in. He's loving it. He wants, the day after the election's over, assuming he loses, he'll be back out there shaking hands and selling books again. That's just kind of his reason to be, if you will. Whole different scenario with Mary Landrieu.
Lawrence?
I think Governor Edwards is having the time of his life. I think he's enjoying it. He's traveling around the district with his wife, talking to different groups. People come up to him. They stand in line to shake his hand. They want their picture taken with him. He's still the celebrity that he was when he was governor. He's still very popular with a lot of people. They still like him. Now, obviously, they didn't vote for him. 70% or so of the people in that district didn't vote for him, but he's having a good time, and you know, I don't picture him going anywhere except heading toward December 6th. I'd be surprised though if Senator Landrieu did not take this to the end. A race for the United States Senate has far more implications than just what happens in Louisiana. We in Louisiana are looking for a senator who's going to represent us on all the issues. But from the standpoint of Washington, they're looking for votes. They're looking for power. They're looking for the ability to control the agenda and to control their programs. There is a reasonable chance that in 2016, this could reverse. You could very easily see Republicans losing some seats in 2016 because they're going to be just the opposite. It's going to be a lot of Republicans that are going to be up for re-election as opposed to Democrats. It was the opposite this time in the election yesterday. So if you subscribe to that idea that, hey, look, 2016 could reasonably be a different day, a different outcome, that one extra vote with Mary Landrieu in the United States Senate could be the difference between 50-50 and, you know, 51-49. So, you know, I just don't picture her not running this to the end.
The other thing I might throw in there, the backing of what Lawrence is saying, is that let's assume she says, like, I can't win this thing. I think I'm just going to shut it down. That has national implications. It shows the Republican, whether the Democrats are quitters and that they've given up, if you will. So they're probably, even if she runs and loses, there's probably the fact that she goes down swinging and fighting, there's some value there for the Democrats all across the country. So there's probably going to be some pressure on her to hang in there and fight it out to the end, even though realistically they know she's got a really huge uphill fight.
Uphill? She, at this point in time, I mean, there are no, or at least in the U.S. upcoming U.S. Senate, there are no Democratic senators from the South. Now, if she wins, she'll be the only one. So, you know, yeah, I mean, should she be the person out there to you know, try to beat down the wall? I mean, I don't know. I she's not a quitter, far from. I know that. But I just don't know what her message is going to be. And that's the thing that I just really wonder about, whether, and if she can't get the money, and if the Nationals are not going to generate the money for her, then, you know, does she want to go out losing 30, 40 points?
Well, I don't think if Senator Landrieu were to lose, I don't think it'll be anything like that. I think it'll be much closer than that. But, you know, again, it has national implications. Now, you know, we're sitting here speculating on what the thought process is of people in Washington who certainly can be off the wall sometimes. Mm-hmm. And, of course, that's why the public is so upset. But, no, I just don't see a scenario where she leaves this contest. I just don't see that happening. I don't see it happening. She's a very capable politician. She's a very capable campaigner, maybe a better one than Congressman Cassidy. Mm-hmm. But I do agree with, I think, what you said and what Jim has said. What's her message going to be? That's going to be the problem. And I don't think it's going to be enough to say what you said in the primary, because you said it, and it didn't work.
It didn't work. I just got an email from her, at least from her campaign, and it was an anti-Cassidy website. And I didn't go to the website, but I looked at the email, and it was basically the same message about Cassidy going into the runoff that she was trying to get out there going into the jungle primary. So I don't know. What is the message?